Picture a man going on a journey behind sight and sound. He has left YouTube. He has entered the Patriot Zone. Good evening, everybody. How's it going? I am probably sweating a little bit because I've had a problem before stream. That's probably why you probably noticed I haven't been communicating at all. I haven't seen the chat at all. Had a little bit of a problem that we're going to be doing the Ferrari tonight. And in issue 73, it's asking for loads of pieces like the... let me have a look here. The fuel caps, as you can see there, we need to fit them. And we need to fit these. Now, these all came in issue 71. I can't find issue 71 anywhere. So I went back and looked at the video that we did last week, and or the week before. I didn't have those parts in issue 71. I had the doors, unless there's a pack somewhere around here. I'm going to have to get the magazine to see what actually came in issue 71 in the pack. Because if I didn't use anything from that pack, it means that I've got a pack somewhere in this man cave, which I can't find. I have got issue 72 here, even though we're starting from issue 73, but issue 71, can't find it at all. So, not sure what's going on there. How's the wrist? I put this on tonight because it's getting worse. This is actually starting to swell up. I've got a ganglion cyst, if you didn't know. You can probably see it there. I'm not going to whack it with a book, but this is just to stop the mobility, because today I've actually built the Routemaster back 7, and that's going to be out next Friday. And oh my god, the amount of seats. You've done the four. There's no more seats to put in the thing. As you can imagine how many seats I had to do. But if anyone... Hello, Kaylin, how's it going? If anyone's got issue 71 on them, can you let me know if we actually used any parts of issue 71? If we didn't, and we're meant to be using them tonight at issue 73... It does mean I've got a pack somewhere, or I'm a pack missing, because they're not in my box or anything. So I'm going to have to figure that out. Hence why, you know, this is up tonight. Build the F40 in 2,500 pieces. Absolute nightmare. There is too many. Well, the thing is, I don't leave them lying around, Carl. It's got its own special box there. And I've got nothing in my box. And I've got every stage since then. I've just got nothing for page 71, for issue 71. So... Hello, Christian from Grampton.
Let's give it up big time. Hello, Christian from Grantham. Now let's get cracking.
I mean, I would get onto them and let them know that, you know, I haven't got it. But seeing as that I've only got up to issue 80 here, and I've paid up to issue 90 odd, whatever you're on now. So God knows where they are. So they're all far behind anyway. And I'm not going to be here anyway to receive it in now. From Friday, I'm on a plane. We've got all our travel money today. So the last hurdle we've got to do is just get through the COVID test on Friday. And then that's it. We're leaving. We're all good to go. So I have already done videos for the Ducati. Ian, you're going to love the Ducati. The front forks are in, as you can see. I've done the Titanic. Up to issue 4, and just about the Titanic, you probably would have saw on Facebook that there is a change to it, that they're going to change some of the parts from issue 1 and issue 13, and I've got those replacements there. So they're going to give you white breakwaters, silver capstans, and sort of yellow steam valves. And then in issue 13, you've got some fairlead rollers and some winches as well that's going to change. And that's the positions they go. Now, when I did the video, because I've already done the Titanic video for Friday, I never glued anything in. So I'm pretty lucky. I can just pop it back out and put the new things in. But if you're not aware of that, then obviously you're going to have a bad time. I am off to my America, David, on Saturday. So once again, my itinerary is Saturday, Sunday, Monday, Washington, Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday in North Carolina and Williamsburg. Then we're in Kentucky, Thursday night, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday to Monday morning at the Wonderfest model show. And then I'm flying out to LA with Phil. So I'll be with Phil in LA for a week. Don't think you said. Yeah, very clever. Wayne, check your emails. This is the result of having that type of cyst removed. Oh, you're just going to give me a horror story now, aren't you? Stand by. I don't even know if I can, actually. Hang on. Let me just put that over there. Because I've got other things to show you tonight. Because I'm aware that we can't do anything in issue 73 at the moment. So we're only going to do issue 74. I only mentioned it five. I'm really excited, Dave. I can't wait. I said I haven't been away for like 12 years. It's, I think I've had my wings clipped. Let me just have a quick look at emails. Stand by.
Pete Cooper, right. This is what the internet's showing as part of this stage. Pete, there was nothing attached to that email. Thank you, but there's nothing attached. The wrist. Yeah. Oh, God, no. I can't be having that. No, I don't want that. Jesus. Thanks for that, Robert. I ain't going to sleep tonight, am I? Oh, it's your wrist. You have one. Oh, what? I thought they drained it. I didn't think they cut you open. You've scared the bejeebus out of me now. Send your mouth picture of the parts. Yeah, there's nothing attached to that mouth, Pete. Yeah. Check the email. I didn't get a picture with that. So. Oh, look, this is where the Wednesday. Issue 71 just had the windows and the filler caps. Yeah, I definitely didn't get it then. Because I haven't got any of that. So, I will have a good look around again. But I keep everything in a box. So, I'm going to have to call them. Now, I didn't check the stuff. As soon as this stuff comes, I just bung it in the box because, you know how much this build annoys me. So, well, we'll have to start from issue 74 tonight and I will get on to them about issue 71. But I want to show you some other things that are going to come to the channel as soon as I'm back from holiday. Now, Mrs. Welda Wayne, as you know, is doing a cute bee Doll's House, Quiet House at the moment. She's actually going to be, once that's finished, doing a book nook, which is a pirate. It's a pirate-themed book nook. It's look like an inside of a ship. Looks really good, and she's going to be doing that. And I, now I do. Let's have a look. Thank you. Just checking. Is that all it was? I definitely haven't had that, Pete. I haven't had that. I don't know if people can see that. That's what was meant to have come. Yeah, I definitely haven't had that. Right, okay. I'm going to have to get onto them about that. Typical. Starts well tonight, doesn't it? They go away on their own, do they, White Glove? I've been told to keep it immobile, but immobile. I can't really do that in my job that I do here. That's why I'm trying to put this on, because it does... Oh, I don't know. I don't know. But I did manage to get an EpiPen. Do you realise EpiPens at the moment, because of my... I had that anaphylactic problem a couple of months ago. Trying to get an EpiPen in this country at the moment is a living nightmare. No one can get them for you. And I was only lucky that I know a pharmacist who managed to get one. So, there you go. Old David, what are we going to do with you? So anyway, look, Pete, thank you for that. I will get onto them and thank you for that picture. So what we got to build? So I'm going to be building this first, which is the Marble Night City. Not tonight. I'm going to be building it soon, just so you know. And it's basically, let's change the camera here. It's basically one of these marble runs. Now, I used to have one of these as a kid, albeit one of the playthings, and when you set it up it was all plastic. You see, I haven't even opened this yet, but this is all laser cut wood, and I am interested to know what's in it. So stand by while I figure out how to open it. And there you go, lots of parts. So we've got all wooden and plastic parts by the look of it, and the assembly instructions, marbles, looks like an emery board, screws. Now they're saying, even though there looks to be a lot to do in that, look, check that out, they're saying don't know how long it's going to take. I thought there might be a thing to tell me how long it's going to take. 10 steel balls. But anyway, I like gadgets like this. I find them calming. So I take it we turn the crank and the gears will make the marbles go around the thing. So I'm going to be building one of them. But you like the Roker kits, right? Well, Kaylin, you're going to love this. This is what I've been waiting for a while. This is from Sterling Kit. Ready? Your pointer is on the screen. Yeah, it happens. Okay, so we finally got, and this is massive, the 5-cylinder radial engine from Sterling Kit. Now, I believe this isn't too cheap. I think this is about $469. Now, they're saying 230 pieces, but they reckon I can get it done in 3 hours. So, as you see, I haven't opened this yet. I'm going to stand by. Let's just make that go up a bit and put that down. Then you can see the whole thing. Oh, now you're looking at me. There we go. Looks like a fascinating build. But this one looks crazy build. Okay, so there you go. Yes, you did, Ian. We did, Christian from Grantham. Okay, so I'm trying to open this. Stand by. I can't even get past the first obstacle. Why won't it open? Ah, there you go. Right, cool. So, again, first time I've actually seen this. We've got the instructions here, which pretty much look like the Nodding Donkey we did instructions. Same company. So, it's going to be all metal, this is. Looks interesting. Okay. One bit of packing. Two bits of packing. And there we go. So, we've got, wow, a whole plate of parts in there. More parts underneath, a propeller. The propeller is metal, looking like that. Wow. Again, the what we used to with the screws and stuff, they're in a, oh my god, let's just try and get this out. They're in like a plastic pot, so we know which ones we're going to be looking for there. And obviously this is a working radial engine, so it's actually going to turn and the pistons are going to go. And look at them. Wow. So I think this is probably going to be the thing I might start with on the Patreon stream. And we'll do the other one on the other stream. It's got a real funny smell to it. You've done the Vitascope. Wow. Vitascope? Vitascope? I've probably butchered that name, haven't I? So that's what's coming to the channel, a radial engine. Now, I don't think this is going to be as hard to build as the Zero Fighter was. But you just saw all those bits in there. And 230 pieces. Remember, the Poacher's got 900 pieces. But they reckon we should be able to assemble it in 3 hours. And by now, it's filthy. So we'll have to see. We'll have to see. So that is coming to the channel soon. Let me just get this on the floor. Wow. So, I've been in here all day today, building things. Phil is going to be babysitting me, bless. I'm just trying to think what else happened. Oh, so the Titanic, as I said, it was going to be out Friday, but I've had to edit, even though the video's uploaded, I've had to take it down, add something, and re-upload it, which is obviously all of those details there as a stop press, which means I had to change the board again, because I've been changing the board every day for every video. On Monday, I think I actually did 3 videos, because I don't want to, when I went away last August to Scotland, I didn't have any content on the channel, and I want to have some content. Obviously, I'm going to be filming from Wonderfest and from the headquarters of Aztec Dummy as well, so we can see what Phil's got in there. So it's going to be quite good. You won't be able to pry those two apart. Oh, I'm just looking forward to it. We've been waiting ages for this, so okay. So let's have a look at the this goddamn Ferrari. I've got, these are all the wrong issues. Look, this is up to issue 80. I'm not with it tonight, am I? Right. So here's my problem. Let's show you this. Change the camera. So this is issue 73 of the Ferrari, which is terrible because you can't see nothing there. Hang on. Let's go like that. There you go. Okay, so in issue 73, they want us to use all the parts that I haven't got, which are, stand by, putting in the two fuel cap filler caps there, and then putting these two bits of window into the car. So I can't do that. I'm going to have to phone them up and let them know that. That was from part 73. Now, if I bring over the car, because the last time you saw this, we had problems with the doors lining up, and I just want to show you how well they line up now. One there. You remember we had the big gap at the top? And one the other side. No gap at all now. And how did I do that? Basically, I didn't screw these windows in. I glued them to the interior panel. I think the screw holes were what was misaligned. And that was stopping that going in. Now, obviously, you can probably see we have got a little bit of a line round here. And there's not really any way I can think of to actually get that in. Can you see? Don't know. Don't know. We'll have to figure that one out when it comes. But it looks a lot better than where we started. And I think this section is the basis of what we're working on tonight. So if we go into issue 74, and we'll look, I'll come back to issue 72. I don't think there's any problem skipping it for the minute. I mean, we've been doing that for the whole build, just skipping bits of, you know, and parts and keeping it to one side. So, you know, it's my prerogative now. So we've got the 1962-50 Testa Rossa, looking like that. And we've got a windscreen. We've got a windscreen wiper. We've got a mirror. And whatever that little tiny thing is there, a washer nozzle. So we're going to be taking some parts from issue 72. Thank God I've dug that one out. And I'm going to be fitting that. So by the look of it, we're not doing anything from issue 73. We're going to be doing things from issue 72. Why wasn't these instructions in issue 72? Okay. Let's do this. I love this build. Can you tell that this is like my favourite build of all time? Okay. Issue 72. So, I've got that here. Let's get this open. And there you go. Chuck this away. And what we got? So we've got an air intake. That's what they're calling this. I've got some size H screws. Whoops, I'm getting everything all over the place. This looks like I've cut my wrists or something, isn't it? I assure you, I haven't cut my wrists. It's just this big ball that's growing on me here. It's like my, what do they call it? When you have a symbiont. I've got a symbiont growing. It's another World of Wayne growing in the end. It only came on Monday. God knows what I've done. There you go. So that looks like that. So we're going to be taking this section, and I'm just checking which way around they've got it. They've got it. Oh God, this doesn't look anything like what the picture is. Stand by. This really doesn't look anything like the picture. Take out the left side air intake included with issue 72. This is the right side. I've just opened the wrong pack, haven't I? Oh, God damn it. It's one of them streams tonight. Okay. Forget everything I just said then. We're going to be opening issue 72. Lucky I looked at the pictures. I look like Keith Bellelevin. So this is a mirror of what we've just done or didn't do. That's better. It's the right way round now. Okay. What cave upgrades? I hear you're off to the Caribbean, Ian. How cool is that going to be? Okay, so this time, yep, that follows the picture. I'm happy now. So this air intake, which we've got here, is going to be going over this lug just there. And I'm going to be screwing it into these two holes here. Please say with H screws. With H screws. Something's going right. Did I swear? I don't think I have sworn, have I? I don't think so, Howard. I hope not. Okay, so let's get the first one in. And that's perfect. And I'll tell you what, I can feel every single screw that I put in today from that, what's it called? Rootmaster. I didn't use my electric screwdriver on account that it needed charging. So, this is all I've been doing today. When you see it, you'll laugh because I did speed it up. But there we go, there's the air intake in. It has got a little L on it, so we know that that's the left-hand side. It needs a polish as well. Once we've done that, let me just turn the page. See what we've got to do. We're actually going to be attaching this to the car. No way. Okay, let's bring that over and figure out where this is going. So this is the left side of the car, and it's going to be going underneath this section here. So it's going to slot in. Oh, hang on. Stand by. I'm just figuring this out. Kind of like that. There. Just looking at it. Yep, that looks good. Once again, we're going to be holding this in with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 screws, which means there's no way I'm doing this without a part work upgrade, Matt. Because we're asking for a bad time. So I'm just trying to figure out how this goes in. Right, that's lined up okay. Doesn't really straighten the door out, I have to say. Yes, Wayne, we're off to Jamaica, third time. I haven't even been once. I'll tell you, it is a country I'd like to go to, though. Right, stand by. Let's see if we can get the first screw in. And then hopefully everything else will slip into place. Oh, so you're going to put up a pink curtain and flower boxes on the man cave so S can take over. I hope not. She's taken over the lounge with her massive 112 scale doll's house. So that's one in. Let's put the second one in. I'm just looking where all these screws are. It doesn't really make a lot of sense. I can see I've got one there, one here, which is a bit hard to get in. I'm wondering if there we go. Having a really, really good high powerful screwdriver helps on this, but just doing this hurts this. That's the problem I've got. So that's one, that's two. We've got one here. I am putting these in oil. Don't think you can see this. Very tricky to get these in. God. So we've got this part here is in the way to get behind for that. So I've got to take it. God. How am I supposed to get that in? I'm thinking how I can get this in. Let's see if gravity will help me to start it off. It has. I don't know if you can see it. There you go. That's another one. And we've got one on this black section here, which goes in there just like that. Again, hopefully you can see that. Very hard to get these in really tight, I have to say. I didn't put any oil in that though, did I? I almost said glue then. Okay, and we got one more just into that last black section there. I can't believe I got bits missing. That's just wound me up tonight now. And I seriously dug everything out of this man cave. Okay, perfect. So that's in place and that's looking like that. I don't know if that's how it's meant to look. I don't know if that's meant to be how big they get. Well, I mean, it matches what's on the door, so I guess it is. And that is all there is to do in that stage. Whew. I'm out of breath after that one. That was a lot of screwing, that one. Let's put that on the floor and have a drink. I should drop the Iron Man on it. As a matter of fact, I think, Kalen, didn't they drop him on a Cobra? I think his first test flight, he fell into the Cobra. So I could do it with a Cobra, I suppose. Oh, yeah, when he smashed his Cobra, that's it. I should read the whole message, shouldn't I? God damn it. I'm not taking anything for it. I'm hoping it's not going to bother me while I'm away, because I don't plan to be building any models while I'm away. Unless this is my beer hand, I don't know. Rewatching your last F40 video, you had the magazine for issue 71, but didn't see the issue 1 pack. Yeah, I don't think I've got it, Chris. So it's when the boxes come, I take them out of the box and put them straight in there. That's it. Stupid me didn't check. So I'll get onto them. I'm sure they'll be happy to send them out. We'll have to see. But I did look back on the video myself because I thought there's no way I could have just lost it. So we're going to be doing issue 75 now. Are we actually going to be doing anything with a windscreen? Probably not. I bet you we're doing the other side of that vent, aren't we? Yes, we're doing it. Look, we've got these parts here. Let me check. We've got this. So that's issue 75. So I've got, just for the record, look, issue 74 with a window there. And I've got issue 75 here. And in a minute, I'm going to be doing issue 76, which is here. So I've got the packs for that, just so you know. So pretty much exactly what we've just done. Let's see what the car was. I haven't got a clue. It was an Adino 246S, looking like that. So we know what we're doing now. We're going to be taking this and some 8 screws. Got one left over from last time. And the air intake, but this time everything's just reversed. So that's going to go on like that. And put this in. TWA is going to have a heyday when Wayne leaves the country. They may have to do a cavity check. TWA. Transworld Airlines. You're living in the 80s, Howard. They're not called TWA, are they? Isn't it like the NSA? I don't know. What are those people called? Homeland Security? I don't know. I only remember... Oh, look, I'm going to show my age now. Do you remember the old Up, Up and Away? What was that with British Airways? I'm sure it was Up, Up and Away with TWA. Oh, I can't remember. I still remember adverts for Pan Am. Okay, let's get the last one in. There we go. You'd rather moan about the pain and take a paracetamol. Damn straight. I'm a man. I'm made to moan about things. Okay, in a similar fashion, we're going to be putting this just into this side here. Turn it over. And once again, get this in place. So I've just noticed, before I do that, what can I use for this? Let me think. I will try some of these. One of my holes hasn't really been punched out on this side here. It is now. There we go. TSA, that's the one. I was going to say, I thought, wow, I'm sure that was an airline. Up, up and away. Okay, so again, I'm going to get the black one in this time. Hopefully that will hold everything in just on its own. It went into his rum. I haven't even had a rum today. I'll be honest with you, I'm just trying to stay really healthy this week. I just don't want my body to... I want my body to fight off every single infection that I'm exposed to. Because there's no way I'm going to let COVID hit me before Friday. After Friday, it can do what it wants. Bearing in mind, I did actually have COVID at the beginning of January. But that doesn't count, unfortunately. It has to be 90 days. The trick is to take as little with you but extra suitcases, because you always come back with more you left you. Well, what I'm going to do, Caitlin, is Mrs. World of Wayne goes home after the first week, and I'm out there for another week. So anything I get, I'm just going to give to her, so I've got an empty case. All my dirty washing and stuff, I'll just give that to her to bring home. Oh, in his rum, misread that. Yeah, I've got plenty of ideas of bringing home model pieces. Is Mrs. World of Wayne you got to be more worried about? The woman seriously has some sort of fetish with fabric. She's got like, first of all, it was notepads, then it was books, and now it's fabric. She's got like a whole, what can be described as a hot air balloon wicker basket full of fabric here at the moment. These ones are really hard to get in. Just under the door. I'm trying to... I could probably go a few more turns. There you go. 1, 2, 3, 4. I've got one more to put in here. Let's not mention the monkey box. They are seriously throwing everything at me, aren't they? It's going to be fun. It's all about the monkey box. That's just my luck, isn't it? Don't get COVID, I get monkeypox. There you go. So that's both of those sides in. So we've got one side looking like that. Does look pretty impressive. And there's the other side looking like that. And that is all there is to do in that stage. So let's put the camera back again. We've got one more stage to do. I'll probably end up doing the others here. Just seeing what we're going to do. Oh, guess what? We get to a circuit board. But we don't do anything with it. Let me just show you this before we build it. Stand by. So we've got the circuit board. We're going to be putting the washer nozzle into the front here. And then by the look of it, we're going to be fitting the window and the rear view mirror and the windscreen wiper. So again, I can do that even with the missing pieces, so that's not going to be a problem. Just so you know, I have already checked issue 76. So I have got the parts for 77, 78, 79 and 80 here as well. But yeah, no parts for that other one. What a pain. What an absolute pain. Just don't forget and leave your credit card in your dirty laundry. It's my passport more of I'm worried about. Not worried about my cards because I've got Apple Pay, so I can get by with Apple Pay, I suppose. But must keep my passport on. But you know what? All you folks over in America, it's going to make you laugh. The first thing that I did when I got all the dollars today was smell it. I just love the smell of American money. The first time I went to America was 1997. And it just reminds me of my first holiday to America. And that smell is going to be with me forever. I'm probably the most weirdest guy you've ever, ever met. I like the smell of money. Literally. But no, American money's just got this distinctive smell. No money around the world has got that smell, trust me. But yeah, I'm a strange one, aren't I? Okay, I'm probably going to leave the partwork upgrades mat down. Let's move the camera around. Stand by. Okay, so let's just see what the car was. I want to know what the car was today. It was Le Mans 1961. Just a generic picture there. So let's see what we got to do. Okay, so we do get, let me just show you this. We do get a control board in this one, but we're not actually installing this yet. So I'm going to keep this in the bag. I've proved to you that I've got it. But this is what we are actually going to be working on. So let me get this open without destroying the mat. Where's me? Where's my scalpel gone? Aha, there it is. Okay, one second. Okay. There we go, and there's all the pieces. So we've got this really tiny nozzle. Excellent. First thing they want me to do is to put the nozzle in. So as you can see on the front of the window here, we've got this little red thing. The nozzle is going to go next to it. Now by the look of it, it's got a D-shaped sort of like hole to put it in. I don't want to break this now. Normally, and Mrs. Welder Wayne doesn't know this at all, so this is news to everyone, the smell will give you COVID and monkeypox. Smelling American money. I won't tell him why. Does that mean people can throw money at me in America now? Why bring cash? Pete, I've got no idea. It's not for me. It was Mrs. Welder Wayne. She wants to bring cash. And I'm shaking my head as well. I don't know why she wants to bring cash. Okay, so Mrs. Welder Wayne doesn't actually know this, but you know my magnifying glasses? They broke. I dropped them and they actually sheared off at one side and I couldn't glue it back together. So I haven't actually got any at the moment, which means I probably will have to nick Mrs. Welder Wayne's until I get some new ones. So I will try and put these in. If I can't see, oh no, actually that's gone in okay, but it's the wrong way around. Let's just turn that. Obviously it needs to be facing to the windscreen. Now, just looking at how that's gone in, it does go in at a kind of angle there. I'm guessing that's going to need to be glued because it just pops straight back out again. They don't tell you to glue it. I'm just seeing if it can be pushed down anymore. Stand by. I think I've got a... Stand by. I'm trying to find... Yes. I've got a helping hands. Oh, you're just looking at me. Look, you can't see me. There we go. Just checking on the helping hands. No, it's just round. It's not a D shape. So I am going to have to glue this in, I'm guessing. Just seeing how they've got it there. So they've got this in kind of like that. Any help? It's going to go down that way, I'm guessing. There we go. So it looks kind of like that. I think I'm going to use a little bit of capillary action on that because I don't want to swamp this in glue. Put that in place and just drop a little bit of that in there. Okay. I think we're good. So, that's that bit in. White glove models needs white gloves. I can imagine Wayne stumbling around the garden having got lightheaded, sniffing them notes. You know what? I guarantee the next time you pull some money out of your pocket, Caelan, you're going to be sniffing it and thinking, what is he smell in this? Although I did hear that fact. Is it true that, you know, that American money's got a certain percentage of, like, am I allowed to say it on stream? White material on it? I don't know if there's any truth in that. Perhaps it's one of those urban legends, you know, but I could believe it if it's true, that's for sure. I could definitely believe it. Right, I don't want to break this window. So it looks just like that, and I'm going to be very gentle with it. Looks just like that. Now, they want me to find the halfway point to put the wing mirror on. So I'm just looking. It's 13... Oh, from there to there, it's about 13 centimeters. So 6.5 is pretty much where this needs to be. Now, apparently this has got, let me just open this pack. It has got a little adhesive on it. So to be honest with you, if I do cock this up and put it in the wrong place, then it's not gonna be a big deal. Now, obviously this is gonna go on the inside and it's gonna be going on the line just in the middle there. Obviously facing that way. That's right, isn't it? Let me just think. Yes, that is right. Okay, so I'll get this little adhesive off. I normally do tweezers with this, but I managed to get it off. Get me ruler out. Measure 6.5 centimeters, which is there. And put this in. Just like that. Hold it for a second, and there we go. We've got a wing mirror in place. Wing mirror, rear view mirror. We've got a rear view mirror. Objects in the rear view mirror, they may appear closer than they are. So once we've done that, this just sits inside here, I'm guessing. It has got some lugs, so I'm guessing I'm pushing these in to the lugs. So I've done the bottom ones. I've done the side one there. This reminds me of the DB5 and how gentle I was trying to be with that. Just looking at the ones on the back here. Not too happy with the back ones. They are, I don't even know if they're in. Let me just take that out. Put the front top ones in first. Let's see if that makes a difference. Top ones are in. This isn't easy. Did I give you any help with this? There are 10 interlocking points. I've got all of these in perfect. It's just these top ones. I think I'd rather wrestle with the top ones than all the rest of them. That one's in, that one's in, that one's in. Aha, I think we're good. There you go. Excellent, we've got a windscreen in. That looks just like that. Ha ha, something's gone right for a change. All we've got left to do is put the window wiper on, and that's gonna be going into the hole that we've got here. And again, I think it's just a push-in. Stand by, just looking at it. Not a very good fit, I have to say. Just seeing where they've got it on the car. They've got it sort of going like that. There you go. Oops. Don't like how that's sitting in there. Stand by. I expect that to be sitting kind of like that, if that's in there. That's the sort of angle they've got it at. I'm just checking that. Definitely got it in the right hole. But it needs to be more that way around. And I'm just looking at this tab. It might be a D shape. No, I don't think it is. Look at the hole there. No, it's definitely just a hole. Little help. Why is this not sitting in here perfectly? I want it to follow the, I mean, it will sit in there, but I want it to follow the sort of like the bend of the window. The way they've got theirs is kind of like that. But you want the whole blade to be on the window like that there. There you go. I still think that's probably going to be, that could be pushed down more. But I've just tried to give it as much welly as I could then, but I mean, it stays in. That's the main thing. So that is all there is to doing that stage. The only thing we haven't obviously done then is these fuel filler caps and these back windows, which were part of issue 71, which I'm hoping I can get hold of. I will have to check their site. Do they actually sell individual magazines? I'm wondering if it would be quicker to get the individual magazine and just buy it rather than have to wait for them to send it out again. Don't know. Let's just have a quick look at what issue 77 is. In issue 77, we've got the rear bonnet looking like that. But we don't do anything with it. You can't make it up. But we are going to be taking the battery pack from issue 27, believe it or not. Wow. And then we're going to be removing the screws that hold the cover in place. So we're going to be taking it apart, basically. Putting batteries in it. And sealing it back up again. So the whole of issue 77 is to go back to issue 27 and put batteries in the battery box. You can't make that up. Okay. You can see the frustration. I've got no words for that. No words at all. Okay, so issue 78. We've got the bonnet. I think that came. Yeah, so we're the big massive thing that I've got sitting down here. You can't even see it. Which, oh, I can't do that. I can't do that. It's, trust me, it's sitting down there. I can't do that because the model that I've got building soon is sitting over there. And I can't show you it because, well, not till next week anyway. And then you'll see it. So that's what we're doing in that. And then we get to issue 80. Someone told me we've got to add some parts to the engine again. It's all bodywork, this is. I don't mind that. If we have to add parts to the engine, I don't think I'm even going to bother. Do you know that? I've actually had what looks like a white filter fall off my engine somewhere. So I'm going to have to go back and figure out where that came from because I haven't got a clue. But the engineer for this car must have been the one that designed the DB5 stages. The problem with the DB5 was even though we had all the bits, in the last five stages, everything come together. But in this one, it's a lot more annoying because they'll send you parts in issue 65 and then you won't deal with it till issue 71. But the instructions for issue 71 would be the whole lot of the parts that you received in issue 65. So it does make you think, well, why didn't you just make part 65s, the parts for 65, 71? I don't know. I don't know. Wayne, is the mirror in the wrong way? No. No, the mirror's in perfectly. I don't know what you're talking about. Look, the mirror's imperfect. You see? It's in fine. I don't know what you're talking about. Mirror was no problems at all. It's been one of them nights like this is what happens when I don't have a Car Crash Tuesday stream. It just all gets built up inside, so I actually do it on a Wednesday stream instead. It's out of stock, is it? Oh, God. Okay. Hello, Todd. How's it going? Todd, we've been having a bit of a nightmare tonight with parts not here, missing parts. Yeah, It's been interesting tonight, but I mean, it's looking. That's the thing with this build, as you can see, it looks good. It's gonna look good. You can tell how it's gonna look good, but getting it to a stage where it's gonna look good is like a nightmare. And the thing is, we did all of that work on that engine. Do I really, really think I'm ever gonna be looking at that engine? It's nice to have it there, but God no, not for the amount of trouble I went to put that thing together. And for me, the hardest part in the engine was to put those pipes on the top and line up, I think it was 8 holes, 4 each side, into the engine block. That was the hardest struggle of any build, I think, that I've had for that. So, cool. Maybe you chucked it out by mistake. I never had it, DRN. Definitely never had it. If I would have had it, I would have had the parts ready when I did the stream, like you saw there. And I'd end up just not using them. So, all fun. Hi, Bergdis, how's it going? You'll have to watch on demand, Bird. This is a little bit of a car crash stream right from the start today because I couldn't find a part. But, it's all cool. It's all cool. If you don't mind, I'm going to put the aircon on. We've got a good 15 minutes. I think that in that 15 minutes, if I, is it 15? Yeah, about 15 minutes. If I put this back over here, and we assume, because, you know, this build is just not in any order at all. If we assume that I've put batteries in that battery box, let's open the bonnet. 1 second. Got that here. I don't know what you're talking about. That mirror was in perfectly. There was no problems whatsoever with that mirror. Of course, Mrs. Wilder Wayne would never notice that because she never uses a mirror. Okay, so let's get this open. I'll flip the camera over. So another iconic part of the car there. I mean, look, check this out here. Just checking what else we've got in here. There's nothing else in here apart from we've got this, and I'm just ripping everything apart to make sure I'm definitely not going to be chucking anything away. Nope, that is everything. Pretty impressive, hey? Look at that. Now this is from, let me get the magazine again. Was it issue 79 that we're actually doing something with this? Nope. Stand by. Issue 80. Nope. Issue 78. Yes. So, let's skip ahead to issue 78. So they got this part here, which came, I've got the pack for, but we're not doing anything with it. But we are going to be taking this, and it says the corners of the bonnet have been covered with a protective film circled in the photo. Do not remove the film for now. And they're talking about, yep, I can see it just there. And a little bit. I think I've only got it on one side. I can't see it on the other side. As a matter of fact, look, this is the next problem. Look, these have got these little silver tabs on. And that's got this film on, which is protecting that from falling out. Haven't got one on that side. God, I'm glad I looked at that. Okay, so let's have a look in that bag that I just had. So, can I see anything in here? No. Nothing there. Nothing there. No. Anything in here? It's only a tiny part, so there's definitely nothing in here. Yep, nothing in those two. Which means the only other thing I had was this plastic thing here. Nothing in there, which means just this bag. And nothing in there. Okay. So I've only got one of these little points here. I mean, are they going to send me a whole part out like this just for that? I'm probably going to fabricate something, to be honest with you. If it's just this little thing here, It looks like a couple of links from a necklace, to be honest with you. I don't know if you can see that. But that little silver thing there, see, should be on that side there as well. But you haven't got anything. You've locked the door. Oh dear. Okay, so it says the bonnet detail that came with issue 77 must be placed inside the rear bonnet. The picture shows two points to be fitted. It must be placed in the rear bonnet. Right, okay, so okay, I'm trying to figure this out. Oops. So they're talking about this, I'm guessing. And they want this placed. I'm gonna put this on the magazine now. It says I have to get the mat out again. I'm just trying to figure out where it goes. So they've got it round. I've got it round the right way. I think they've got it just over. Nope, stand by. Figuring out. Oh, they've got it down here. So that's going in there just like that. And it says, take a type B screw and start fixing the two components using the holes highlighted in step 78. B screws. Where did I get B screws from? Okay, stand by. It's not over yet. I'm thinking. I'm going to find some B screws if it kills me. Just getting out my big box of tricks here and looking for B screws. Aha! B screws. Right. B screws. God knows what stage they came in, but I've got them here. See what I mean? I don't miss anything. I just put them straight in the box. So we're going to be putting, let me think. Right, one in here. Excellent. Looks like we need six. I've only got four. So I'll put one in here. I'll have to find another two from somewhere, won't I? And this one, there we go, that's going in. Perfect. I'll put one down the bottom here. Excellent. Take care, Kaylin, see you later. One here. And then finally, they just want two here. I'll leave them for a second because I want to see what that looks like. There you go. That does look quite impressive at the back there, doesn't it? So when this section here, because I think we'll knock it on the head there, I'll find some more B screws in a second. When this section here is going to be attached to this section here somehow, I'm guessing that's going to go in here because obviously there's a hinge on that section. It's going to kind of look like that. Flip back the camera, you can get the idea. Pretty nice, huh? Okay, so I think I'm going to leave it there. God knows how I'm supposed to put this up on the channel because everyone's been following the F40 build. I don't know what I'm going to do. I'll figure that out later. I'll edit it tomorrow and figure out what we're going to do. I haven't got a clue. Only needs four to hit the corners. Yeah, that's what I've done. I've got another two in there. I know I have. I saw them. But if I haven't, then I'm sure I'm going to find something in this big box of screws. Look at it. Every spare screw I get, I just bung another one in there. So it's all good, isn't it? I'm scared to mention my backlog, but I do have parts for 20 videos. Minus some extra LEDs for the fire truck. Wow. Burgess, you know what? I did the Routemaster today. Now I do have box 2 for Magora models of the Porsche, but I won't be doing that till I'm back from America. I've still got the Volvo to do. Other than that, I am completely caught up. I've got nothing else now apart from the next four stages, or three now, because I've just done one of the Ferrari. So I'm up to issue 80, and that means 20 issues to go. I have paid for the next 12 issues and I still haven't received anything. I think they're having problems just like everybody else is trying to get things through. But I think after this stream, I'll send them an email and just say, what's going on, issue 71, I've got no parts. When's the Ducati latest being released? Wheelie Wednesday. So it's coming out next Wednesday, Ian. So you'll get that. The whole front wheel, brake system and forks are in. So that took me half the day as well. I could probably do another one tomorrow, actually, so that there's something for next Wednesday as well, which is cool. What have you peeps been up to anyway? Tell me what you've been up to. Obviously, Berg, this you've been moving house and you've got the you've got a backlog of things to build now. I have had notification of the Ecto-1. I still haven't received issue 35 of the Ecto-1. I've had notification of another Eleanor. I think that's it. I think I've had Knight Rider notification as well. I haven't received anything else. Are you getting a jigsaw puzzle, Wayne? No. That jigsaw puzzle is this build. It's like a 3D jigsaw, Ian. You had a rucksack with the Iron Man build delivery today. See, everyone's ahead of me with Iron Man, which is pretty handy because obviously there's nothing to do. I say I'll do it on a Tuesday live stream and it's like 10 minutes worth of build time and that's it. Ed, you've been doing wheels for the Jaguar. Oh, my heart goes out to you. I've got one more to do. Obviously, I need to put the tyre on the last one we did from Pack 7, but one more. But it does get easier. I mean, doing the Leopard Tank, all of those. I mean, we haven't got to do any more tracks now, but that was monotonous. As a matter of fact, out of 81, so there's 162 individual tracks. There's only one track that I had to put in the drill press to drill it out because the drill hadn't gone all the way through, which I didn't think was too bad. There is a live stream tomorrow, Sheldon. Always try and do a live stream on Thursdays. Probably not going to be one next Thursday because I'm going to be on a plane to Louisville. But the following Thursday, definitely, I'll be with Phil. And in LA, it should be around about midday. It should be midday in California. So I'll be doing like a midday stream. Ian bought a sword on your transition to becoming a Viking, Ian. What's your Viking name? Sorted mum out with a doctor's home visits, a cancer ward, a hospital. So busy day, all well with mum. And Apple Studio turned up. Oh, that's cool. I went to see my mum and dad today. So my dad's he's got diabetes as well as Parkinson's, and that he's losing some sensation in his feet. Although his feet are okay at the moment. So I don't know. But I did tell them nothing is to go. I don't want to know when I'm in America. I just don't want to know. Tell me when I come back. Because for me and Mrs. World Away, and it seems like every time we go away, something happens. A workshop gets built. Don't buy a Range Master cooker. Why is that? Your channel's called Spider's Brew. John, send me a link in email, and I'll check that out. You got an Eleanor up to kit 50. Would be nice to get the rolling chassis. I mean, I've got at the moment 1, 2, 3... I've got 5 rolling chassis in here. The Fast and Furious Dodge Charger I can't fit in here, so that's upstairs at the moment. You're rebuilding a guitar. You know what, DRN, that sort of thing does really well on YouTube. Anything restoration or rebuilding. Templar Crusader, Wayne and Shield. If there's a zombie apocalypse here, and I know who I'm going to come and see. 6 months old main oven door lock fell off. What is it? We never had this problem back in the 70s and 80s, did we? Or was that just me? I'm sure we didn't. Things were made to last. Look, I've got it up there as proof. Things were made to last. Unlike this stream, unfortunately, because it's now time to go. So, no video on the channel tomorrow. The next video is going to be on the channel is Friday. We're going to be doing the Titanic. And by that time, hopefully, David, if you didn't realise, I'm going to be going to the airport to fly out to America. And then obviously I've scheduled some videos for next week as well. But if you haven't subscribed and you haven't clicked that notification button, there may be impromptu live streams because you know what we're like. I just stream whenever. We'll have to see how that goes. But the Patreon, as for the Patreon channel, I won't be able to draw the Patreon stream till I'm back on the 12th. If I do get a chance to do it on the 1st, which I haven't got a clue what day, it'll be the 2nd. I normally do it on the 2nd. If I do get a chance to do it on the 2nd, then I'll go on my laptop and we'll do it then. So that's all good. So I hope you enjoyed it tonight. Even though things have gone wrong, I've got to try and find a home for that now. And it's all good. So take care of yourselves. Look, there is my, you're right. Look, there's my little pointer on the screen. That's crazy. Take care of yourselves, and I'll see you tomorrow.